brothers and sisters. And Theron was also a very enterprising person in the sense he loved to play his guitar, and he had some favorite songs that he would always sing. And as time went, Orville, Theron and I, we floated a company called OET Enterprises. And we were going to export timber to Japan. So Theron was the chief man because he was also working for a company who were dealing with timber, VDP Fernandos. And so it went on that he sent the samples to Japan and never got a reply back because the trees were all crooked. So this was not a big joke. And we had another cousin, Roper Tyler. He was a planter. Roper and Theron were also very close to each other, and they were both pit rats. Both pit rats. And we sort of, you know, just carried on in such a way that, you know, when I came to Australia much longer after Theron came here to live. And I ended up in Hallam because my sister, Annie and Andy, they sponsored us. And so we sort of, you know, met all the other cousins also, you know. And we went on and on and on and on, but we never forgot to have a big party and a sing song whenever we got together. And most of the sing songs were at Orville's place. Like when Andre was born, they had his christening, and the christening party went on till about midnight. We were singing and singing and singing. Anyhow, that's how things were. In the process, we had another cousin, that was Roper Tyler's brother, Arlo, who passed away. He was a fisherman, a deep sea diver. He passed away, and he spoke to Fatima, who voluntarily allowed us to use their family grave to bury Aro. So then that was the story. So Robert came down when Aro died, and he stayed one night there, and that was the end of it all. Robert never came back to Colombo. He was all the time there in Sydney. And he had specially mentioned to convey his sorrows at the passing away of Theron. So that's about all. Thank you very much, everybody.
We now have the Psalm 23 read to us by Amy.
Psalm 23. The Lord is is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table for me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Thank you.
In the Old Testament, there is a book called the Book of Job, which I'm sure many of us have read. But there is a beautiful story of Job, who had many sons. One day, his sons are in the fields working when the angel of death strikes them and they fall down dead. The servants come and tell Job that his sons are dead. And everybody was waiting to hear Job curse God or find fault with God. But when Job opened his mouth, he says these words: "The Lord gave and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of God." I chose this passage because I think it is a fitting passage for today as we remember the life and ministry and the service of Tiron. A husband, a brother, and a friend to many of us who are gathered here. God gave Tiron to this world. I'm sure there are many of you who will be able to spend the whole night today in telling stories about how he touched your life in a certain way. And can I ask you, for those of you who knew him personally, try to remember at least one incident that you keep alive today. It might be a happy time, it could be a sad time, it might be a time when he made those special stories that he spoke about, but something that brings him alive, because he is alive. As Christians, we believe that death is not the end, but death is only a changing of our mortal body into a spiritual body. We know that Tiron has sacrificed his earthly body for scientific research. But that doesn't mean that he's ended there, isn't it? His soul is now in the presence of God. And today, as we gather, as we thank God for his life and witness, we also come to thank God for his life and to offer his life once again to his Redeemer and his Creator. Our Lord says, "Those who believe in me, though he be dead, yet shall he live." Our Lord says, "I am the resurrection and the life." And as Christians, each and every one of us are baptized into the very faith. For we believe that one day we too will meet our loved ones. For those of you who come from Sri Lanka, I'm sure most of us are from Sri Lanka, will remember that beautiful hymn that we sing at funerals. "In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore." This is our faith. That's our hope. And this is what we proclaim today. That death is not the end, but death is only the closer nearest with God. I'm sure that as Tiron was taking his final breath, he would have heard the voice saying, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You have run the race that has been set for you, and now you have come to claim your crown of glory." Yes, Tiron ran the race. He struggled with earthly pain and suffering, and where he is now, there's no more pain and no more suffering. for he's truly been released from his earthly life, and now he walks in the presence of God. So let us thank God. Let us, as we come with heavy hearts, say, yes, Lord, you gave him to us, and now we come to give him back to you. Amen. You know, we have this song, It's a Sin to Tell a Lie. I'm not sure how I fit it into the sermon, the service, but let's see. It might be Tyrone trying to say something to us today, isn't it?
Yes, I will. Talking of members of the OET Enterprises, I should say the managing directors, there was many a day when those three managing directors used to come to our home with my dad, because, and this was during the week, it was a weekday, we were all sleeping, we had to go to school the next day. And after a good booze, because my uncle Edgar used to live at our place, and they were singing until late at night, Orville, Edgar, Tyrone, and my dad playing the guitar. And this is a song that they used to always ask my dad to sing, Uncle Edgar, Orville, Dada, if you like, you can join. My dad used to like this song a lot. It's called, It's a Sin to Tell a Lie. It's not meant to be disrespectful in the second verse, but this is how it goes. This is a 1920s song, and this is exactly how it goes.
I can't even remember the words.
They show it's true when you say, I love you. It's a sin to tell a lie. Millions of hearts have been broken just because these words were spoken. I love you, yes I do, I love you. If you break my heart, I'll die. So be sure it's true when you say I love you. It's a sin to tell a lie. Cross my heart, swear to die, I never, never, never tell another white lie. Took my little girl out to a date last night. Next to her sat a pretty girl, she looked alright. Now between the devil and the deep blue sea, oh my honey, she looked good to me. I tell her I love her, but oh how I lied. And now she's getting ready to be my blushing bride. If she leads me to the altar, I'm sung. Cause I can tell the preacher I was drunk. So Lord have mercy on an old town sinner. Give me one more chance to have another guy winner. Cross my heart, swear to die, I never, never, never tell another white lie. It's a sin to tell a Lord Jesus Christ, you gave new birth to our brother Tyrone by water and spirit. Grant that his death may be called to us your victory over death, and be occasion for us to renew our trust in your Father's love. Give us the faith to follow where you have led the way, to live the reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit to the ages of ages. Amen. And as we come together as a family, we say our family prayer together, saying, Our Father, which art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it has been in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother Tyrone. May our farewell express affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again with the love of Christ which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Let us pause for a moment as we prepare to commit the soul of Tyrone into God's merciful hands. And we say together, Holy and loving Father, by your mighty power you gave us life, and in your love you have given us new life in Jesus Christ. We entrust Tyrone to your merciful keeping in the faith of Jesus Christ, who died and rose again, save us, and now live and reign with you in the Holy Spirit forever and ever. Amen. Saints of God, come to his aid. Come to meet him, angels of the Lord.
Receive his soul and present him to God most high.
May Christ who called you take you to himself. May angels lead you into the arms of Abraham.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Grant him eternal rest, O Lord, and may your light shine on him forever.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Let us pray. God our Father, we thank you for the life and witness of this our brother Tyrone, whose soul now we have come to hand him back to you, O Lord. Lord, as we truly believe that he is now walks in paradise with you, we pray for Fatima's wife and those who love and care for him and those who mourn. We pray, O Lord, that the void that has been created through death will be filled by your presence, and that someday we too will be able to meet our loved ones beyond that shore. We ask all this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. The peace of God, which passes understanding, keep your hearts and minds in knowledge and love of God, of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be with you and those who mourn, today and forevermore. May the soul of Tyrone, the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Let us pray for this food as we bless this food. God our Father, we pray for this food that is set before us. Bless the hands that prepare this food for our use. Bless be mindful of the millions who have no food on their table. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. We have the last song. No, there was you.
So this very last song is one that every time I saw Uncle Tyrone at my place or at his place or at Tiger's or whatever, is to always ask me to sing this song. I hope I can do it justice. It's a Paul McCartney song. It's called Till There Was You. I hope you can join me in singing this.
Service, and I'm sure the conversation will not end here, but we'll carry on through the evening. So please feel free to speak about and enjoy the time, and knowing that he's looking down on you, and I'm sure he'll join in as well. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.